This is the AFERIY P210, and today we are gonna put it to the test. To start, we're gonna jump into the tech specs breakdown, then we're gonna go into ports report, because he's got a lot of ports, and then we're gonna go into a segment I like to call Can They Lift It? I like this one a lot because I get to have my boys and my wife involved, see if they can lift it. Following that, we're gonna go into the energy endurance test to make sure that the capacity is what it's stated at. Then we're gonna do an inverter stress test followed by pros and cons, where I break it all down and tell you what I think based on the previous tests. I'm Eric with East Texas Homestead. Let's jump into it. Let's start with the tech specs breakdown. The AFERIY P210 has a 2400 watt AC pure sine wave inverter built in, as all of these power units do. It has a 2048 watt hour lithium iron phosphate battery. They say that it can recharge from 0 to 100 in 2 hours with AC power alone. The battery will last 3,500 cycles down to 85%. If you cycle that one time a day for 3,500 times, that's essentially, it's a little less than 10 years. That is a really long time, and I doubt most people are going to be doing that. When it comes to recharging, you can recharge 4 different ways: with AC wall outlet, with solar, with car, or with AC and solar. So it's not really 4 different ways, it's really 3 different ways, but you can do 2 of them together. As far as the outputs are concerned, you actually have 16 different outputs. Some are AC and some are DC, and we'll go all over all of those in a moment. When it comes to solar input, it has a maximum of 500 watts of solar input. And this unit, like many, can be used as a UPS backup, which is really nice for certain situations, and we'll talk about those as well in just a bit. So next, let's talk about ports. This thing has 16 ports, and it says that you can use up to 14 of them simultaneously. So let's walk through what we've got here. So on the left, we start off, we've got a cigarette lighter. Then we've got our 2-barrel 5521. These are 12 volts by 3 amps. And then we've got an XT60 down here. All of these can be turned on or off by pressing this button right here. You turn it on, you see we've got the XT60, we've got the 5521, and then we've also, this kind of makes me laugh, it's a picture of some, like a smoking cigarette, which is hilarious, but I guess it accurately depicts this as the cigarette lighter, right? That's this section right here, and it can be controlled independently. Then the next thing is we've got these ports down here, and you can turn them on here. These are your USBs, and it's depicted by a symbol of the USB type A, and you've got 2 of those, and they are 3.0, and then we've got the power delivery USB-C, and we've got 1, 2, 320 watts, and 1 100 watt. So that's great for powering high draw devices like a MacBook Pro or something like that. So we turn those off. Also, I want to point out that you can turn both of these on simultaneously, as well as the AC, which I'll push right here, and now you see the AC, or the sine wave, I guess the alternating current emblem right there. So this is one of the probably weirder things for me, and that is that the AC is actually on the side here. Got this lift gate, if you will, and then here we've got 6 20 amp outlets. You can tell they're 20 amp for those of you who may not know, because the one on the left has the little slant going out like that, and that's also 120 volts versus the 20 amp 240 volt, which would have the slant going out to the right. Finally, we come to the inputs. Turn this around. All right, we've got our XT60, right? XT90, and our AC power plug. Last but not least, there's a little cubby right here, and this is where you can keep your cables or anything else that you would like, your manual. This is the PVN. This is that XT90. Said it's larger, and it will not plug in right here. And the back of the unit simply has some of the specs and stuff that you might wanna know. You can pause it and look at it there if you'd like. This next segment is something I call Can They Lift It? It's basically where I have my family members see if they can lift and carry around the products that I review. It's important because if the family can't move it and I'm required to do it, is it something that we actually want for our family? That's a question that you're gonna have to decide. And hopefully this segment will help you understand, can they lift it?
That's pretty heavy.
You think you can carry that around?
Probably not.
And remember, always lift with your hands.
What?
Not so great. Okay.
Too heavy. Too heavy.
Oh my gosh. Okay, well, I don't think I'd be walking around with this very far. It's real heavy.
Next up, we're gonna do a capacity test, and we're gonna use this monitor here. And what we're gonna try to do is pull exactly 20% of the battery's capacity, which is a 0.2C discharge rate. And so what that's gonna do is give us the industry standard for discharging. We're gonna see here in a second, what we should be looking for is just over 400 watts of output. I don't know why it's showing any, oh, just kidding, input right there, because I've got it 100% charged. So, input's gone. We're gonna start our test, and we've got 453 watts. I'd like to see it drop down a little bit. I've been adjusting things. Here we're at 430, but I think that's close enough. This is showing that we're gonna have 4 hours on this test. We're basically just gonna let it run, and when it hits zero, we'll come back and we'll read how many watt hours that we have put through it. And then we're gonna divide that number by the total capacity, which is 2048 watt hours. We finished the test. You can see we're down to 0%. Nothing's coming out, nothing's coming in, no time remaining. So unplug right here and then reconnect to power. This is gonna give us how much energy has come through. And it looks like we've got 1.83 kilowatt hours. So we'll take 1,830 and divide that by 2,048. And that's gonna give us 89.3%. It's lower than 90%, which is kind of the bar. So I'm not crazy excited about that. I would like to see it a little bit higher. 90%, 93, 94 would be great, but that's where we're at. So definitely not the best performance. The next thing that we're gonna do is a series of load tests to see how well this unit can hold up to certain things. First thing we're gonna do is use our charge verter, which is a 48 volt battery charger that can output 5,000 watts, and we're gonna charge up our large 48 volt batteries that are run off of these inverters behind me. This is gonna give us a real world test to see if we can push this unit past what it's capable of and what happens when we do that. So to start, the charge verter is typically run on a 240 volt setup. Since we're doing 110, we're gonna step that down and lock that in place. I'm gonna plug this in over here on the side. So the charge verter is set to do 22 amps at 48 volts or 52 volts. The great thing about this charger is that it slowly ramps up the amount of power that it's drawing. And so it's gonna give us the ability to give the inverter a bit of a soft start. We're gonna do some more complicated stuff later on, but this is what we're gonna start with. So I'm gonna turn on the AC output. You can see we're drawing 20 watts. It's gonna slowly ramp up, and I think it's gonna be somewhere around the maybe 1200 watt range. All right, there's 1200 watts. All right, we're at 1372. That's not bad. Let's see if we can push it a little bit farther. I now have the charge verter set to 32 amps. Let's see what happens. 1000 watts. So far, no problem. 2400 is supposed to be the max continuous. One thing that I love about this unit is that over here, it shows us exactly how much time we have remaining. So we know that if we were to put this load on this unit, we've got 45 minutes. And that kind of gives you a little bit of an idea of like, what could I actually do with this? It's not a silver bullet. It's gonna get you through certain things. It's helpful in certain areas, but it's not gonna run your whole house all day. So we're cruising right around just under the 2000 watt mark. Let's put a little bit higher load on it. Okay, so we're doing 42 amps coming out of the charge verter. So we're coming up on our maximum here. Let's see. Oh, it kicked off. Maybe we need to back off of that just a little bit. So I'm not sure why it just dropped down and kind of reset. So let me look at the charge inverter. It's showing that there was an error and we're gonna need to start over. So I'm gonna drop it to 40 amps. All right, we're gonna try 40 amps and see what happens. Sure takes a long time to ramp up. All right, we're getting close. Let's see what happens. Can it hold it? Fans have kicked on. Oh, did not like that. Did not like that at all. Okay, so it started over. Let's turn this off for a second. All right, we're coming up on our 2000. There we are. See if we can hit like 22 and hold it. Ooh, there we go, 23. So this is 38 amps at 56.2 volts. And that's given us just under the max. So let's let it run like this for a minute and just see. Really, the fans aren't even on. Actually, the fans aren't on at all. So let's see if we can hold this for a while. It seems to be doing fine. Now, what happens if we add another load? Oh, I didn't even get it in there. I didn't get it in there. It shut down. So unfortunately, it failed the test of putting out 2400 watts continuously. So let's move on to the next test. In this next test, we're going to try out its surge capability and see if it can start up this big old 12-inch miter saw and just try out some everyday Homestead stuff. Make sure it's on, it's 100% charged, and we're gonna plug it in over here. All right, I've got my eye protection and my ear protection on. First thing we're gonna do is just see if this thing can start it. Oh, it sounds pretty good. Let's see about cutting a piece of actually it's probably 2x6. This is cedar that we milled a few years ago. Pretty good. All right, I call that a pass. It smells really good too. Next, we're gonna see if we can start a 1200 watt load with this heat gun and then see if the saw starts up and if it sounds different, has a little lag or anything like that. So here we go. Well, it's showing 1000 watts. I know you probably can't see that, but it's like 1015. All right, now I'm gonna go ahead and start up the saw at the same time. (laughs) 2200, looks pretty good to me. But what about a shop vac? Let's see how this works. This thing is nasty and old, but it takes a lot of power. All right, so let's wrap things up. Let's talk about what I like and what I do not like about the P210. The first thing that I like, I really like these handles. It's easy to carry around, at least for someone around my size. You know, my kids, some of them had some issues with it, but overall it's pretty easy. I don't think it's heavy enough that you need wheels on it. Some of these models come with wheels, but I think this one's fine without it. Surprisingly, I really like this little guy right here. I thought it was gonna be a bit gimmicky. Like, what am I gonna put in there? Like my snacks or something? Probably not a good idea. But it holds the cords really well. I love the display. It's probably one of the nicest displays that I've seen. It's got a really clear output, how much time is left. Even like the gimmicky little cigarette symbol, it's super clear. You know exactly what that means. So I love that. I like that it's got a light on it. I haven't personally needed to use the light yet. It is there, and I'm sure from time to time that could be helpful. I'll likely take this camping with me, and it'll give me a good idea of, you know, how easy or convenient that feature is. I do like that it has a 100 watt port on it, but I wish it had 200 watts instead of 320 watt USB-Cs. I do like the 5521 ports on it, because now that I've been utilizing my Starlink Mini, being able to plug directly into that makes a big difference. And I just really like that. So overall, it's a pretty decent unit. Let's talk about the things that I dislike. It definitely failed two of our AC output tests, which kind of bummed me out. It didn't quite hit 90% on the battery capacity, and it also did not hold the 2400 watt continuous output longer than around 80 seconds. So that's somewhat disconcerting, but every other thing that I've done on it, it's held up really well. And I think as long as you're not trying to max it out, it works well. So for the price, it's a pretty decent unit. There's just, it's not 100% as good as advertised. So that's just my honest opinion. Another thing that I don't love is that the PV input is only 500 watts. If you're relying on this thing to get you through off-grid situation where like this is your power source, 500 watts of solar, it's roughly a fifth, a little less than a fifth of what it's capable of putting out. So you're not able to recharge from solar as quick as you're able to discharge. And so if you're like going to run a refrigerator nonstop or something like that, you're not even going to be able to keep up with it if you have the maximum amount of solar going into it. But let's be honest about if we're going to take this camping, how much solar are you going to take with you? You know, the portable solar suitcase style solar panels are typically like 250 watts. We've got another one here that we're testing out right now that's 100 watts. So how much are you really going to be carrying around? 500 watts is probably good enough because most people will never max that out. Now, if you've got it at home and you're going to have a whole bunch of solid aluminum and glass panels that you're going to set up on an array and then try to run your whole house off of this, that's not what this thing is made for. This is a portable unit that's made for occasional use or to be used as a UPS backup. That's another thing that I liked is that the UPS function worked really great. I've got another unit that I've reviewed in the past that I gave to my grandmother, and it is running her oxygen machine and a lamp so that when the power goes out, like it did a lot this spring, it just seamlessly continues creating oxygen and leaves a lamp on in her house so that she feels comfortable. I think this unit would be just as good at that application. As always, links in the description below, and I will put a QR code right here so you can scan that if you're watching on your TV. Yeah, that's it. I'm Eric with East Texas Homestead, reminding you to live faithfully and prepare thoroughly for good times or bad. Check out this video right here. YouTube thinks it's best for you. We'll talk to you on the next one.